Win the incredible Steiger Craft, Evinrude, Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package, and more in the Fisherman's 2018 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details at thefisherman.com.
After a couple of weeks of sketchy weather, looks like we got another hot one this week. And as a matter of fact, this weekend ahead looks just beautiful. Light winds and light seas as well. Perfect opportunity for you to get out and score. I'm Jim Hutchinson with the New Jersey Delaware Bay edition of the Fisherman magazine. Took a little of my own advice this week, got out and scored. Took a little trip on the bingo out of Atlantic Highlands this week. We actually had a trip with the IGFA, the New Jersey chapter. Took out a bunch of kids, some parents, father time. Great event where we got on a bunch of porgies. Had a lot of variety. Porgy, a couple of sea bass, one keeper in the back in the Raritan. Also, those big rays. It's been fun. Actually, I was out on the beach this past weekend. Caught three of them. The first one is a little frustrated on a bucktail, but by the third one, started appreciating that big cow nose ray stripping off line and really making for a blast. But there's a lot of rays. We've been hearing of them in the surf and the Raritan and the back bays. Definitely summer variety has set in, and some of them couldn't give great tug on the line. Now, I mentioned this weekend coming up, light winds. You might hit one of those situations where you're out there in the hot weather and not getting a real good drift. I got a nice note from Don Mace of Pottstown, PA this week. He fishes out of Ocean City, and he was talking about those aimless fluke drifts. He was solo fishing Ocean City Reef over the weekend on his 19-foot scout and working a productive piece of structure, but again, that wind wasn't doing him any good. But he got down to an 8.2-pound fluke, fishing one rod with a 3-ounce S&S bucktail. One of the things that Don said made it all the difference in the world, that trolling motor, making use of the electronics. The trolling motor was able to get him through. Also used the side scan sonar to be able to find that most productive piece of structure. Don also recommended don't be afraid to come back to a piece of structure if you hit something. Ocean City Reef, Axel Carlson, you hit it in the morning and you're not real productive and you go someplace else. Hit that structure later on in the afternoon. You never know what you're going to stumble into a little bit later. Never know when those fish are going to turn on. There are some good fish offshore in that structure in South Jersey. Matt Corman, as a matter of fact, he took first in the South Jersey region in the JCAA fluke tournament over the weekend with an 11.78-pound doormat. Weighed in over one stop bait and tackle. So those big fish in the deep water, in the structure. And hey, if you know about that 12-pounder, if you were following the JCAA tournament over the weekend, $50,000 for the top fish over 12 pounds. Don't you know that 12-pounder brought in over the weekend, the folks there were not registered in that $25 Calcutta. If you're going to be in it to win it. Get in all of those Calcuttas if you can, but that 12 pounds will be the mark, I would assume, again next year, 2019, when that JCAA tournament comes around again. Some of the very best fluking that I hear of course, outside of Bellamar, all the way up here on the Raritan Bay, that deep water, Ambrose, and the Shrewsbury Rocks, that deep water structure. There's quite a few big fish. In fact, farther down in central Jersey, a regular name on the Fisherman Magazine's Dream Boat Leaderboard, Phil LaGrossa brought an 11.5-pounder, 30.5 inches, over to Betty and Nick's Bait and Tackle over the weekend. I would expect to see that one bumping somebody off the Fisherman Magazine's Dream Boat Leaderboard by the time this weekend comes around. I know New Jersey's Bill Berg, he put an 11.9 on the board last week. Congratulations, Bill. We're at the point where 11 pounds is gonna be the cutoff if you're in that Dream Boat contest. We had a couple of sea robins today too. Don't forget, sea robins are on that Dream Boat Leaderboard and those hubcap porgies as well. Congratulations to Tom D'Alfonso, who's 16.5-pound Mahi, 16.6. that he weighed in at Sterling Harbor Bait and Tackle last week, put him in second behind fellow New Jersey dolphin fisherman Gene Camiolo and just ahead of Bruce Doritas. Summer variety, we are in that summer variety mode. I talked to you about those cow nose rays. Gary Adair hit this Mahi inshore with a few triggers to boot. In fact, he saw a cobia hanging out by one of the sea buoys as well. On top of that, Gary's one who's been fishing in the back bay a little bit, catching some sheepshead out back while making quick work of that one tog limit in New Jersey. Now, don't discount your anchoring opportunities. You know, this is time of year all the way into September where you can anchor up, do a little bit of chum pot fishing, catch some spots if you're in South Jersey for the bait season coming up for the stripers. Also get in some of those puppy drum, all kinds of stuff. Perhaps dropping a crab or a crab jig near the structure, along the sod banks, along the bridge abutments. get yourself one of those tog and also a sheep's head as well. Also give thought, mentioned that before, those sea buoys. I know some guys in South Jersey, they scramble to be the first people, the first guys at those sea buoys coming out the inlet first thing in the morning. Black bombers, live eels, live baits, bucktails. You'll see those cobia hanging out. Cobia love those black bombers, live eels, any number of summer visitors right there. It's just phenomenal. If you just have those polarized glasses and take a look, you might be surprised what you might stumble past. In fact, Andy at Riptide had a customer bring this photo in for him to ID. Andy sent it over to us. My guess was an Almaco jack. I think I might have been half right. Somebody else said a bar jack. We do think that was a bar jack, but you get some of those jacks in as well. These bar jacks, though, not very tasty, but they do make great marlin bait, I've been told. Haven't caught one of those big blue marlin, but we've got one of those coming up in just a second. Wait till I see that. As far as being half right, how about this one? I love making fun of news headlines. Fox News out of Florida. How about this one? A new Sunshine State bluefin record. Was actually an 826-pound bluefin, not a bluefish tuna, go figure. Speaking of tuna, Hudson has been hot for bigeye and yellowfin, Massey's too, to the south. Try Chicken Canyon for bluefin. Do hear of some bluefin still out there. In fact, this is, like I said, a perfect weekend to get out there and try those offshore grounds and the mid-range grounds. 10-year-old Mako Visozzi, he fished with his dad Joe on the family contender out of Manasquan Inlet and hit this good 60-pound bluefin. And it does, like I said, look like a terrific weekend ahead. 1 to 3s from Friday through Sunday and light winds, that's offshore, from the Hudson to the Baltimore, good opportunity. Down off the Baltimore, off Maryland, through Friday, of course, we've got that Ocean City tournament, the White Marlin Open continues through Friday. Last I checked on Wednesday, a 75-pound White Marlin for Florida's Bill Haugland stood atop the leaderboard with $2.6 million on the line. That's a heck of a fish. Joel Rahman and crew, though, they took this 888-pound blue marlin earlier in the week, an impressive fish worth, get this, $700,000. On the way down here today, coming out of Atlantic Island, saw the signs, had to look it up. Sandy Hook surfcasters who came down to Sandy Hook on Wednesday found out that the park was closed. That big storm that we had come through here on Tuesday knocked down a couple of poles. You might have to check if you're thinking about getting out on Sandy Hook to try for some of those fluke. Definitely take a look first. I would hope by Thursday afternoon, at least by this weekend, they'll have that all repaired and coming down. Like I said, great weekend to jump on one of the party boats. If you don't have a charter, you call up and you're like, oh, I can't find a charter. We'll jump on a party boat. Jump on with the kids, get out there. The porgies are up here. We got great opportunities for fluke. And of course, in New Jersey, don't forget, you have that 2 black sea bass limit and 1 tog to carry you through until the fall as well. Catch them up this weekend. We'll talk again next week right here at thefisherman.com.
Win the incredible Steigercraft, Evinrude, Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package and more in the Fisherman's 2018 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details at thefisherman.com.